our 13 steps for marking your assessments. When it comes to marking assessments here at Surrey, we've been able to respond to your feedback by talking more about how we ensure our process is fair and consistent. Through this short guide, we'll show you each step of the process that we follow for every piece of summative work that you submit. Academic staff work through this process, but we're also supported by more than 200 external examiners, academics from other universities, who help to ensure that we're doing things fairly and consistently, both within the University of Surrey community and compared to other universities. Step 1. Your lecturer sets your assessment. A team of Surrey academics make sure that the type, amount and weight or value are right. One of our external examiners might also review the assessments that we've set. Step 2. Your lecturer shares the details of your assessment with you, including the nature and timing of your assessment and how it will be marked. They may also share any marking criteria or grade descriptors to help guide you. This may all be brought together in an assessment brief. Step 3. Lecturers answer questions that you may have about the assessment, either in your seminar or via discussion boards on Surrey Learn or Q&A sessions. Please do make use of these opportunities and be aware of other sources of study support that we can offer you. Step 4. You submit your assessments or sit your exam. Step 5. Assessments are normally marked and students provided with constructive feedback within 3 semester weeks of the submission deadline. But remember not to count any non-semester holiday weeks in this. Exams, final year projects and dissertations also follow a slightly different timeline. Step 6. A sample of work is looked at by a second lecturer to ensure that there's fairness and consistency between assignments and modules. Step 7. Some assessments, like dissertations, are marked twice by 2 lecturers using blind marking. They then meet to agree a mark. Step 8. If there are any disagreements, we have marking teams who meet to resolve these. Sometimes marks are raised or lowered. Step 9. Your provisional marks and feedback are then released on Surrey Learn. During the 2020-2021 academic year, a safety net will be applied to ensure that you're not disadvantaged in terms of your final grade through no fault of your own due to the pandemic. Step 10. You can't ask for your work to be remarked, but external examiners review samples of work, then report to and attend a board of examiners. This part of the process ensures that marks are fair and consistent across all modules and are in line with other universities. Step 11. They may find an unusual range and ask for an adjustment. This is rare and is very carefully reviewed and approved by a Senate committee. Step 12. Your provisional marks then become agreed on your student record. Step 13. The university reflects on outcomes across all programs. We hope that this has been helpful to explain all the stages that your work goes through. If you would like more information on any of this, or if you have further questions, please reach out to your academic hive for support.